Every time you drive a boat, turn on a pump, possibly even start your faucet, tiny and destructive underwater explosions occur. These explosions are rapidly generated steam bubbles caused from boiling water in a process called cavitation. The basics of cavitation are based on Bernoulli's principle. It states that the pressure of a fluid decreases as the velocity increases and vice versa. In combination with this idea, we have to remember that the boiling point of water changes based on the pressure it's under. This is why pressure cookers make cooking more efficient. When we grasp these concepts, we can begin to understand why cavitation occurs. Whether you realize it or not, you probably have seen cavitation for yourself. Those bubbles that float to the surface behind moving boats are actually results of cavitation. For boats specifically, as the propeller spins fast, it increases the localized speed of the water around it. This creates a low pressure zone on the trailing side of the propeller. This low pressure zone causes the water to boil at ambient temperatures of the fluid, so small steam bubbles are created due to boiling. These steam bubbles then implode due to the surrounding pressure of the water, then form again due to the energy transferred from the implosion. For marine engineers, cavitation is to be direly avoided. These underwater steam explosions are fascinating to an observer, but to a propeller, they're incredibly destructive. When cavitation occurs on or near the propeller of a boat or inside pipes or pumps for that matter, it chips away the surface layer of the metal. It may be hard to understand how exactly small implosions in water can destroy metal. But you need to understand both the relative energy of the implosion and the relative damage it causes. When a cavitated bubble implodes near metal, it causes high-frequency vibrations on the surface of the metal, which begin chipping away the surface. Eventually, after constant cavitation occurs, layers of the metal are slowly chipped away, possibly leading to catastrophic failure. Cavitation can also be mitigated in propeller design. Top-secret submarines use specialized propellers that mitigate cavitation to reduce on noise and stay covert. Anywhere that water undergoes a rapid change in velocity, cavitation can occur and cause significant damage over time. The effect creates problems as to the longevity of impeller pump designs. As water is sucked up into these pumps, if the fluid pressure at the inlet is lower than the vapor pressure, then added energy from the impeller can start the cavitation process. This cavitation then continues in the fluid around the impeller, significantly damaging internal mechanics. Cavitation again occurs in pipes in valves. If you were to switch on a faucet or open a valve too fast, cavitation can and does occur in the transition area of the fluid involved, most likely water. Like mentioned before, this cavitation will damage the pipe or valve over time, creating the possibility of catastrophic failure down the line. Cavitation is only one example of the extremely powerful and destructive effects of physics all around us. To those unaware, it's a great unseen danger to engineering around the world. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, you can see more of our content here and here. You can subscribe to this channel to stay updated on every new video that comes out every Monday here. And if you really believe in our channel, you can support us on Patreon here. Thanks for watching.